it's Taylor. As you can see by the title of this video and all the cute little clips that I put in the beginning, this is my Cinderella-inspired prom tutorial. I am so, so excited to be giving this one to you guys. This was like one of my favorite dresses ever. Like, this is definitely my favorite prom dress. I think it's so fun and pretty and poofy. And of course, it was inspired by the new live-action Cinderella movie, which was so cute. I was just so in love with it, so I decided to go ahead and make that the inspiration for my second prom video. I really hope you guys enjoy this. If you want to figure out how to create the Cinderella look, then go ahead and keep watching. So as you can see, I started by putting in my Luxie hair extensions. I didn't show you guys this on film, but if you want to see a separate video for that, I was thinking about filming one, so go ahead and leave me a comment down below if that's something you guys are interested in. Then I'm using my Tresemme Thermal Creations Heat Protectant Spray, and I've just sprayed that throughout my hair and brushed it through just to protect my hair from all this heat that I'm using. Then you'll see that I realized that I had skipped a step, so I started curling my hair, but I wasn't supposed to. I went ahead and changed into a shirt that wasn't falling down so much, and then I started teasing my hair, which is what I was supposed to be doing first. I like to tease my hair here just to add a little bit more volume and body, and also to make the tiara look super pretty. I just think that having your hair teased in the back helps the tiara to look really pretty. I think it sits well on your head. I don't know, that's just personal preference for me, but now that I'm satisfied with how much I've teased it, I can go on and start curling. I am using my Conair Infiniti Power of Pink. It was a limited edition, I think, but it goes towards breast cancer research, and it's one of the ones that is bigger at the top and then it gets smaller towards the end of it, so that's the one I am using, and I am just going to curl all of my hair with that, and I'm not going to bore you guys with watching the whole thing. The main thing I want you to see is what I'm doing here, where at the end of each curl, I'm just pulling it and bouncing it to make sure that it's not super tight. I want to make sure that I do that to each curl to kind of let it out a little bit, loosen it up, and make it super pretty. Now obviously I am not blonde, but this technique does create very similar curls to what she was wearing in the live action Cinderella film. Obviously this is not like the cartoon because she had her hair up in that, but since I'm wearing a strapless dress, I thought that this hairstyle just fit better because I prefer my hair down when I'm wearing strapless. Next, I'm just going in with this tiara that I purchased from Charming Charlie. Can I just say what a great day it was, the day that I had an excuse to buy a tiara? But then I am pinning some pieces of my hair just to cover where, I guess, the tiara meets my head. You just want to make sure that this is super comfy since you're going to have a long night of dancing and having fun with your friends. You don't want to have to be worrying about how uncomfortable your hair is. Excuse my little Disney music break there, I was just getting in the mood for the Cinderella video. Next I'm going in with my Garnier Fructis Flexible Hold Hairspray. This is perfect for this kind of curl. And then I am all done with my hair look. To start off my makeup, I've done my brows, and now I'm going in with the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade Yogurt. And I'm just going to rub this all over my eyes with my ring finger so it's not too harsh on my skin. Next up is this Pacifica eyeshadow single in the shade Ethereal, and I'm just putting that all over my lid and on my brow bone highlight. This is just a pretty shimmery, champagne-y highlight color, so I'm putting that all over with a fluffy brush. Cinderella has a very natural makeup look in the live-action movie, so that's what I tried to mimic with this color. Then I'm going in with a white highlight shade and just further defining the highlight underneath my brow bone, just because that's a place that I always like to really accentuate. I think it's very pretty. Then taking a brown taupey color from my Ombre stretch palette from Magic Colors, I am putting that in my crease, just again a very natural shadow, and then I'm taking the Ethereal color and putting that again over my lid just to brighten it up a little bit. Next I'm taking the Milani Bella Eyes Gel Powder Eyeshadow in the shade Bella Chiffon, and I'm using that to highlight the inner corner of my eye to give myself that really innocent Disney princess type of look on my eyes. So then you guys know me and sparkles, that was not enough sparkle for me, so I'm taking some eye drops and putting them into a soap dish, and then some sparkles from Hard Candy that I got at Walmart and putting those in the other side of the soap dish, and after I do my liner, which I forgot to show you on camera, I am going to dip my brush into the eye drops and then wipe off all the excess moisture, and then dip it into the sparkles and be patting those with a flat brush all along my lid. I want this to be very sparkly and very dramatic. You guys know me, I like sparkles, so I decided to add some extra here. Then what I don't get from the brush, I'm going to be patting onto my eyelids with my fingers just because this provided a better application for me. So I just want to make sure that the eyelids are heavily saturated with glitter because glitter. And then when I'm done with that, I'm just going to be taking an empty eyeshadow brush and rub it underneath my eyes to get rid of any excess or fallout. Next, I'm going in with the NYX Jumbo Eye Pencil in the shade Electric Blue, and I'm just going to be doing my waterline on the lower lash line and just the regular lower lash line underneath my lashes, just to make sure that I get a lot of color payoff from this color. It's so pretty, and it matched my dress perfectly. Next, I'm just taking a paper towel, and I'm going to be wiping away any excess shadow or glitter. Now for my favorite mascara, this is the Tarte Lights Camera Lashes Mascara, and I'm just going to be coating my top and bottom lashes with this pretty heavily on the top especially. If you guys want to use falsies for this look, something nice and delicate and wispy and flirty is totally fine, but if I did that it would cover up the sparkles and I didn't want to do that, so I just went without and used mascara instead. Then to start off for my face, I'm using this NARS Radiance Enhancing Pro Prime Light Optimizing Primer. Wow, that is a mouthful. This is just a nice primer to kind of help the light really reflect well off your face. I thought it was perfect for this kind of sparkly Cinderella look. Next up is my Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation in the shade 128 Warm Nude. Now, I do have a separate video coming out for this product very, very soon, so I'm not going to go into too much detail, but I'm just applying that with a flat, dense brush from e.l.f., and I'm just applying that all over my face for an even coverage. Now I'm using my new Naked Skin Weightless Complete Coverage Light Diffusing Concealer. Wow, could I pick any makeup that had a nice short name? I'm using this in the shade Light Warm, and I'm just applying that in certain areas as you can see here and blending it in with my Beauty Blender sponge. This is the greatest concealer I have ever used. I'm so happy I got it. Next to set that, I'm using the Wet n Wild Coverall Pressed Powder in the shade Fair. This is just a nice light powder that's going to help me to set the under eye area and help it to not crease. Next, this is a little bit out of order. I'm using the Maybelline Dream Bouncy Blush in the shade number 5, Fresh Pink. This is a cream blush, so normally I should have done it before I used any setting powders or anything, but it just slipped my mind and I forgot. Normally, though, yes, use all your cream products first and then your powders to set. But then I'm just setting my face with the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder in the shade 120. I believe that's called Classic Ivory. And then I'm using my Too Faced Chocolate Soleil Bronzer. This is a deep matte chocolate colored bronzer. And I'm using that to contour my face. I don't want a super harsh contour because Cinderella is more of a fair, light complexion and I don't want to contour too much. Plus, I just don't feel like I need it for this look, but I did want to do a little bit of something just to add some dimension to my face. Once I'm done with that, I'm going to go over my blush area with the NARS Orgasm Blush. This just adds a little bit of shimmer, something that I thought this look could use, so I just decided to go over my original blush with that one. Next, using that original Pacifica eyeshadow, I'm using that on a thinner pointed foundation brush from e.l.f., and I'm going to highlight my face with that. So on the tops of my cheekbones, I really want to make sure that I highlight there, then a little bit on my nose, and really, really focusing on my Cupid's bow to make my lips look a little bit bigger, and just, I think that this is, creates a very innocent look, having the extra shimmer and stuff like that, so I decided to use that also. Now to set my brows, I'm using the NYX Tinted Brow Mascara in the shade Espresso, and then I'm going in and setting my whole face with the Model in a Bottle Makeup Setting Spray, which is perfect for everybody, but especially oily girls, because this is a matte finish and it keeps you matte for the entire night. It is brilliant. Next, I'm using this Covergirl Colorlicious Lip Gloss in the shade Give Me Guava. This is such a pretty peach golden toned lip gloss. Then I'm using that Pacifica eyeshadow and dabbing it again on my Cupid's bow, and then a little bit in the center of my lower lip just to make my lips look a little more plump. And that is it for this Cinderella inspired makeup look. I think this is so pretty and sweet and innocent, and just the Disney princess vibe is so gorgeous, I think. Plus, can we talk about all the sparkle, because it's seriously giving me life right now. If you didn't think that that was enough sparkle, you could also use this Charming Charlie Shimmer Dusting Powder, which comes in this cute little bottle, and just, I feel like, completes the shimmery princess look. So guys, my dress is from that glam prom shop. I don't know if you guys have it, but it's kind of like a pop-up prom shop that just sells prom dresses during the prom season, but I will try to have the designer and style linked down below for you guys as well. And can we seriously talk about this twirl? Like, there is so much tulle on this dress, it made me so happy. It did make it kind of heavy, but it was totally worth it to look like a princess for a night. There was so much detailing in the rhinestones, from having them all over the bodice to kind of trickle down the skirt, which I thought was a really pretty detail. And then my shoes are rhinestone booties. They're actually from a boutique in North Carolina, but I will try to have their designer and style listed down below for you guys as well, so you can check them out. And that completes my Cinderella-inspired prom tutorial. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I certainly enjoyed making it for you, so thank you so much for watching. So guys, that was it for my Cinderella-inspired prom tutorial. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was so much fun to make. If you liked this video or it helped you out in any way, be sure to give it a big thumbs up for me. And if you want to see more of my videos, go ahead and click subscribe down below. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you next time.